Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2213. Save as using VBA, but keep the original open. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gillen. Well, you might have noticed that I've been offering the download of each podcast recently because a lot of people have been asking me for that. And so I was trying to make life as easy as possible. And the whole goal was to save a copy that you can download, but I didn't want the extra stuff, the stuff that's for my own internal use there. So I wanted to get rid of that. Let's say that I had a situation where I had to write 12 workbooks, right? Each with a different product. So I'm going to loop through these products and I'm going to write it there to A2 and then save the workbook and maybe clean up some stuff. All right, so my first pass through here is a macro like this. All right, so we define the current workbook, worksheet data, worksheet report, define those. And then figure out how many rows of data we have today. We're going to loop from row 2 down to the final row, copy the product from the data workbook over to the report workbook. All right, and now here's where I'm about to get into trouble. So the new workbook's going to be called C:AAA and then apple.xlsx. And I'm going to save as a, with the apple.xlsx and change to XML open XML workbook, which will strip the macros out. All right, but now I'd like to close that workbook. But unfortunately, when you do a save as, see right now I'm in podcast 2213. When I do a save as, after that point in the code, I'm no longer going to be in podcast 2213. I'm going to be in apple.xlsx. All right, so now if I want to start deleting stuff, I'm going to be deleting it in the copy, but when I close the copy, well, I can't get back to the original file, right? And this macro, actually my head's about to explode trying to figure out if the loop will still work or not work, right? So I think save as is the wrong way to go here. Well, actually, hang on. We could go two routes. First, I could have another workbook that opens podcast 2213, does the stuff, and then saves as with the new name. Or I'm going to go this way. Right, and this is the method I ended up using. All right, and we're going to define this workbook, but then also a new workbook. Right, and everything is kind of the same down here until we get to the point where I was about to do wbt.saveas. Check this out, save copy as. Now this doesn't exist as far as I can tell in regular Excel. This is VBA only. Save copy as says, hey, look, we're in a file called 2213. And I want you to take that file 2213 in its current state and save it to disk and close it. Keep the original file open. 2213 stays open, but now we have a brand new file on disk called apple.xlsm. Actually, at first I'm just going to call it deleteme.xlsm. All right, but it creates an identical copy and keeps the original file, the file that the macro is running in, open. And that's the important part. All right, so now that I have delete me out there, I open it, assign it to WBN, do the things I need to do, get rid of all the extra sheets I don't want to have. Notice before you delete the sheets, you want to do display alerts equals false, otherwise it keeps asking you, hey, you're not going to be able to get the sheet back. I get it. And then finally here, select the first worksheet. FN is going to be apple.xlsx, and then we can do WBN.saveAs apple. As an open XML workbook, no macros. And then close. The beautiful thing about close is I'm now back in this workbook, 2213. All right, it's been working really, really well. And the key to this whole thing is save copy as. Save copy as. So to me, while that's been around for a long time, I never used it. And now I realize there's probably been a lot of times in the past where I should have used it. And maybe, you should be using it or consider using it as well. Oh, hey, I forgot to mention one thing. The important thing is with save as copy. So when I do the save as copy, if I try to change to an XLSX file type, I cannot change the file type here just by changing the extension in newfn. And when I try and open that subsequent workbook, they'll detect that it has macros and it has the wrong extension and it will yell at you, right? So you have to save it as XLSM and then later come back, reopen it and save it as XLSX. But that all works with this macro. So hey, when I'm update this book, Excel 2016, this summer for Excel 2019, I'll make sure to include this this tip. I think it's a useful tip, the save copy as. Wrap up from today, you want VBA to write several copies of the current workbook. Save as causes problems because the original workbook is no longer open. Instead, use .SaveAsCopy to save a copy of the workbook. If you want to download the workbook from today's video, including the macro, visit the URL in the YouTube description. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.